everybody. It is me, Rebecca with a K. It's Touch Taste Thursday. I know it's been a while, and we're back. Season 7. Literally season 7. It's been since 2020. It is now 2024. If you've been following me for a while, you know that, I don't want to my own horn, but kind of been doing this for a minute. Like, I'm not new to this. I'm true to this. This is what I've been doing for a while. And just want to give y'all some background information. Just kind of want to update on what I have been going on. Let me know if you all can hear me. Let me know if you all can see me pretty good. I need to make sure that you all can hear me and see me. Drop something in the chat so that I know that you're there. I'm going to bring on Johnny Domino. If you are from Baton Rouge or even the surrounding areas or just beyond, really, you know who Johnny Domino is. You know, he is a media mastermind. You know that he is that guy, the go-to person, especially if you want to get into music, media, entertainment, whatever it is. He is that guy. So I'm going to bring him in. We're going to get him started. Again, this is season 7. If you have been rocking with me since 2020, again, you know that season 7 is legit. I just add numbers and just create stuff like that. So y'all know what it is. Y'all know it is Rebecca with a K. And if you've been following me from the Gene Ella collection, Rebecca with a K is two different people. Rebecca with a K is me. I am Rebecca with a K. Gene Ella collection is the brand, is the company, is the business. And so Rebecca with a K, it's a lot more right to the point. We're going to cut the shit. We're going to get right to it. And that's just what it is. So I'm glad you all are here. Thank you guys for tuning in. I'm going to jump on with Johnny in a second. But make sure you're sharing this live. Make sure you are telling everyone Touch Taste Thursday is back. In the comments, it says we bike like plies. So I'm going to get Johnny on while y'all are sharing. We are back, season seven. I don't know how many times I say that, but season 7. You count them up, season 7. And the good thing is that it's documented. So it's not like I was just, doing something else and I decided to jump on IG. I've been doing this for a minute. I am an originator in the IG live game. And it's been a wild ride. But you know, it's been great. It's been great. I met a lot of wonderful people just doing what I do, doing naturally. I met a lot of people using the gifts and talent, the time and the treasure that God has given me. And that is how I met this gentleman, just randomly on the fluke. Came working to show up, you know, ready to work and just helping out a friend with something she had going on with her project at the Getaway Studio. And he just saw what it is that I do. And he was like, yo, who are you? I said, Google me.
I always say it for real.
I said, Google right. me.
We
and I meant
telling the truth. We telling the truth today. Amen. All right.
Yes. Welcome to Touch Taste Thursday. You are guest number one of season 7. Listen.
We got cut up then.
I've been in the game for a long time, 4 years.
People, congratulations on your consistency.
Thank you. Yeah. I don't know how consistent it is, but you know what? I ain't even gonna hold y'all. I'm gonna just get to the point. A couple Sundays ago, I was in service at church. Shout out to Love Alive, and I just heard the Lord say, "Go back to the basics." Right. I had been waiting for people. They wanted to do this. They wanted to do that. We gonna Facts. Help you do this. We gonna build a studio. We gonna whatever the case was. And I kind of just kept waiting and waiting and putting it off and just whatever. And I said, "You know what, God? What is it that I need to do to continue the path that I was on?" Because I was just having like a whole lot of internal turmoil, just whatever the case was. But like I said, I was in service that Sunday and I heard the Lord say, go back to the basics. So here we are on IG Live in my little home studio, on the phone, IG mobile. We got it going. We are back.
Straight up. Me too. You know, yeah, I'm on the phone, man. Before I got a camera, I was on here.
Yeah, facts. Me too. Me too. So let's go ahead and get right into the meat and the potatoes of it. This is Johnny Domino. First of all, tell them a little bit about who you are, because we have a lot of people that tune in from across the country that are not familiar with Johnny Domino. They're not familiar with Getaways or Getaways 2.0. So just give them a quick, brief synopsis about you and who you are and what you do.
I am Johnny Domino. I am an entertainment catalyst. I am the creator of the Ghetto Ways brand. I'm also a consultant, a media consultant. I do production, film, acting, television, movies. I'm on Netflix right now. Show in a Showtime show called Your Honor. I'm doing political consulting as well, helping trying to get candidates that I believe in. You know, let's kick it off. You know, candidates that I believe in that I've talked to myself,
Facts.
and I've asked them the tough questions that people tiptoe around, and then ain't nothing like trying to get to know somebody when you just come straight out with it and say, "Hey man, look here, they say this about you. What's up?"
Right.
Yeah. Ah, I'm asking you like a man or like a woman in your faith. They say you be doing this today. What's up? Because I can't work with you if you're doing that. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
So, and I thank God, man. And then like people got to realize, like I done had a lot of people work with me, try to help me. I had a lot of people. I got a manager now, right? And
From
so,
Panama.
yeah, I got a manager because, man, I'm not gonna ever act like I know it all. And if there's a smarter brother out there who can assist me, I don't mind sharing this bread that I be getting. You know what I'm saying? 'Cause it's like when I realized like we really don't have media. So that's why I couldn't deny you, 'cause you went straight to the basics, and not only to the basics. Journalism ain't nothing ducking and hiding. You
Right.
got people asking you questions that people know you affiliated with Ghetto Way, put him on the stand. You know what I'm saying? So you ain't see me get mad. I ain't say, damn, Becca's GW, man, gang, gang, man, what's up, man? You ain't supposed to do that. Nah, if we being accountable and we gonna be a real live media source, call one of us out. Call one of us out, man, like you just did. Like I respect that. I respect that. I'm glad I got people like you around, you know what I'm saying? Who gonna look, dog, I'm getting questions. I don't know how to answer them. I need you to answer them.
So let's get to that. So let's talk about why, not necessarily why we are here, but let's just kind of get to what began the motion of us being here tonight. A lot of people know, or a lot of people have now, I guess, gathered that I am one of the partners of Ghetto Ways 2.0. And that, it's always an interesting thing because people will see Ghettoways and then they'll see Ghettoways 2.0 and they'll group it together. And then they would say, oh, well, I saw this and I saw that. And I'm like, well, you have to understand that Ghettoways, the person, is someone completely different. That's his personal page. So that's his thoughts, opinions, whatever. And then there's Ghettoways 2.0, which is the media site, which is also a conglomerate of other people doing things.
Of righteous people, cause like y'all look, let's keep it G. Like people be needing to know this, cause like look, first of all, I'm my own man. My manager worked for me. Like Pimp C say, you know, Pimp C, you know, Pimp C, when Pimp C say something, don't blame that on the bun. You know what I'm saying? That's the pimp said that, and a fight come with that. Nah, we ain't fighting no more, pimp. But you know what I'm saying? It's like, man, whatever I do, I've been a grown man. Like you can't even name my big dog. I gotta tell you who my big dog is.
Correct.
I got to tell you what grown man I respect out here as a man, not no gangster.
That
You
part.
see what I'm saying? So the life I live, man, it all check out. You know what I mean? So it's like when I'm out here fighting, and I know that when the police whoop you behind, you come get me and Gene.
Correct.
When the council people get on, we come in there like, what up? And who? Nobody paid us.
Right.
We work. Work and fight. So when we get too old to fight, our grandchildren ain't got to be worried about that bull, 'cause we done fought it already. You see what I'm saying? Like this, what I want anybody watching this who care to see what's happening or what the real is. Think about it. If you call me when the bullies get you, when the police get you, when the crooked cop get you, when the braid cage get you, when the school need to be shut down, when the school board need to get checked, when a school board member need to get checked, I could take care of myself, homie. I could just do it for my family and be a selfish. I'm trying to change my language, you know, but I'm still Ghetto Ways. I could be a selfish brother and just take care of my family because I earn enough. I'm a real grinder, and it's all legal as long as I pay them taxes, baby. You know what I'm saying? So it's like what I see a lot of is, people are try to use you up for so long, but when you play gullible and when you play stupid and when you give them all of it, and people always talking about matching energy. Since you met me, what has changed?
A lot. I mean, not as far as like how you are direct or when you're sharing information, anything like that, but a lot personally for me has changed, meaning
Well,
that
you got to see
my
some growth.
profile has changed and I've grown. Yes.
You got to see me grow a little bit too, because ghetto ways was new for me. It's like all I do is tell the truth, and I stand on it. It's like you can't pay me to. Nah, you're not finna pay me to lie to nobody. Like, this the thing. People got to realize. People keep saying it's politics. It's politics, though. You know what I'm saying? It's politics. It sound like a car salesman. You know, like what does that mean? Because this is my real life. These them real kids that really need help out here. It's like somebody asked me, and I like the questions, man. Y'all got to understand some stuff I don't even want to talk about because you're foolish. And I got so much stuff I got to do, and so many people got to help. People don't go out there and look for the political people that you're seeing now. They call me, you get away. We got to get on the phone, do investigate. Who got paid, Becca? Who
Nobody.
worked there? You know what I'm saying? We done made money. We done got ads. We got to go hustle for what we want. We
Correct.
got to go sell something. I don't care. Yeah, we got to go sell an ad. Feel what I'm saying? It's like we do this for the love, for the passion. We try to keep the thing alive because people won't get away because they know I can't mess it up no more. You gonna vote me out? They gonna vote me out. I'm like, let's do this. No. That's why I made the other getaway page though, cause I hate feeling suppressed. I hate feeling like I'm part of it. Yeah, and like you could be my friend, but if my friend, you could be my family, right? I'm on a different path.
And a lot of times we do talk about a lot of the things that are posted or a lot of things that go on, only because we are very mindful and we want to be taken seriously as a news source. We will fact check, we're gonna research, we're gonna pull together resources. We're not just posting random stuff just to get likes and shares and all of that stuff. Now, sometimes there is some random stuff and I have to text y'all and be like, yo, what we doing? Like for the
Look,
4 steps of
yeah,
good,
we
we
get
did
checked.
five, we doing
Becca
bad.
checks us like we be getting them eyes, the eye thing, like the little side eye, like what y'all doing, man?
Yes. But I think people just need to know, like, the purpose of Getaways is not only user submitted information, it's real time information so that, it's coming directly from people that are being impacted in the moment. And a lot of times people don't realize how just sharing, a car wreck or sharing somebody injured or sharing some good news, some positive information, community news, how that gets traction to our local news, and that also gets picked up by national news. We have a lot of things that we've
We're
covered over the
national.
last year that I've been a part that's been picked up nationally. And so I don't want people to ever feel like, oh, Getaways, they just ghetto, they just
Nah.
ghetto, they just
That's why
whatever.
I was
No,
trying to
we
make sure
doing
I was
real
on
work.
here. I went live at 8 just to let them know, man, I'm on time, baby. I'm on time, and I respect your time too. And then I seen you went live, say, oh, I gotta go get on Becca live,
Wife
But now, nah, like,
woman, when it comes to time, I'm gonna be on time.
oh man, you don't
But
play, man. You be on
let's talk
me.
about like some of the things, because a lot of people feel like I am your secretary, or your assistant or something. So
I'm
they'll
insulted.
text me or message me and say, well, what is Johnny talking about? What I thought.
I'm
So let's
insulted.
get to let's like I like I knew the segment.
Secretary.
Let's cut the shit. Let's get to the point.
Come on.
The question that came was about your support for, at the time, mayoral candidate Ted James. And more recently, you've posted your support in for Coach Sid Edwards, who's in the runoff with our current mayor, Mayor Sharon Weston Broome. And so the question was like, yo, what's up? He was so behind Ted, and now he's jumping behind Coach. Like, what's up? And so I wanted to get it directly from you. Like, well, what's up?
Well, after I gave the people Ted, and I gave it to you like no other, We ain't run, we ain't hide, we ain't duck no cameras. You know, I kept like this the part y'all don't know. I say, Ted, let me get her. People got to realize where I come from, like who I really am. I'm from the hood, I'm from the streets, I'm from Quito, Maine. Housing Authority Project. I done did a lot worse for a lot less. You see what I'm saying? So it's like when we work in campaigns and we trying to run and we trying to win, I believe in this dude, I wouldn't take it. See, I do mine differently. I get recruited, but you gotta come sit down and talk to me because I can't go sell my people nothing and you don't deliver. So me and you got to talk and have a situation. Me and Ted met on Perkins, Oliver Twist. Me and him by himself. No bodyguard, no middleman.
Right.
You know? So check number one. I knew I wanted something different off the top. You know? I liked it. You know, Ted talk, he did a daggone good job. But the voters didn't deliver. Know, we gotta all take responsibility for what, 'cause I gave you another option, but you let a little media trick. Like, I talk so much, I wish they would release my audio. I'm gonna do a video the next day, like, yeah, I mean all that fucked up shit, you know? I meant that. You know, like, yeah, I said that, you know, but this the thing. It's like every campaign I joined, I chose them first. And I'm recruited now because I know how to consult. I know how to make my people understand this politics crap.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like you got to look at it like you, I man, I was down with that party, and I was down with. I even did the black thing, vote black. Vote black, man. Vote black.
Right,
Like
right.
you gotta have transparent, y'all. Man, what y'all lie so much for? If you didn't change yourself for real, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, man, I'm not with the people. I'm looking at my people. Oh damn, I can't help it. I ain't got nothing either. I'm working my butt off of them. I may take care of mine, but sometimes I ain't got nothing extra, and I won't give. But I ain't got it. But I'm making it.
So then with that, do you feel that, like you said, you want to change? A lot of I would say our age group, you know, that 35 to 45, maybe 50-year-old professionals, we were just looking for what was going to be different from Ted, what was going to be different from Mayor Broome, what was going to be different from Coach Sid and the other candidates as well.
Right.
What led you to the point where you said, okay, I'm going to have another discussion because now, unfortunately, Ted is not in the runoff. And so now we're in a situation where we have a runoff with, like I said, the current mayor as well as Coach Sid. What made you say, okay, I'm going to have a sit down with either one and see where they are going and where they're headed and what is going to lead to my next decision?
First off, if everybody tell the truth who was really into it and who was really pulling for change and the people, like I started seeing beauty again, like happiness and like love and hugs, and it was, I ain't gonna lie, I kind of got caught up in it. So when he lost, just like the rest of everybody who was rooting for him, I was mad, sad, like
Right.
damn, man, like y'all didn't want that, y'all don't want him. Ooh, woo. We got a bigger problem than I thought. Like, call me gullible. You know, maybe it's my new thing, the politics, but it's like, I'm like, man, this dude finna win, man. Like, we finna win. And things gonna get better. Like, I was there. So
Okay.
I had the night of, I was like, the next day, you know, everybody was driving and I told you, you know, the regular, you know, you lost. You see, they don't even like when you take your L well. Ain't nobody gonna tell you I curse them out. Ain't nobody gonna tell you I talk bad to them. They crack a little joke. You know, all
Right.
right. I lost. I'm not a sore loser. I'm a warrior. So my first thought was F that whole thing. I ain't doing nothing. F everything. F both of them. I don't know him. I don't know enough. I know her. I don't want that no more. I'm gonna just let the voters that didn't come through for who I had with me, Well, I believed in at the time. You know what I'm saying? We ain't deliver.
Right.
Then the independent showed up, man. The independent showed up. See,
okay.
That's my people.
The
independent. That's who I want to roll with.
So then let's,
the people who don't like either party.
So then let's move into a little bit deeper. So, you know, we have all of the sound bites that were coming out, all of now the slander and different things like that. You know, we had a lot of questions that a lot of people wanted to ask or have answered. And with these debates, they never really got to the meat of everything. You know, they had questions. And so some of the questions was about this arrangement that was supposed to have been taking place between Ted and Mayor Broome about one running and the other one retiring, or however the situation was supposed to play out, and it did not. So immediately, a split of the Black voters. Being in the campaign, what was the conversation like? How did that go when it was clear that there was a clear divide? Because if you look at the numbers, if you look at the percentages, it was a clear divide of the Black voters. Whereas had it been one candidate, there would not be a runoff. We would clearly have a declared winner.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's like this, Beck. Like you gonna get stuff no matter what you choose.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's like the people put the rumors out there on him, but where is that? Like, where the proof?
Mm-hmm.
I can put a rumor out about you right now. Is it true?
I mean, depending on what it is, maybe.
But I might be able to spin it just right and make it people cause a little doubt and make them, damn, I don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And that's enough to spark another sway. You know what I'm saying? But it's like this, man. When you start really digging down into people, see, like, I dug into Coach to try to give me an excuse to find dirt so I could say, yeah, that's why. See, I can't deal with her or him. See, both of them, man. I can't deal with neither one of them. Y'all deal with that for 4 years. I'm gonna stay out y'all way. Yeah, I ain't going nowhere. I'm scared of none of them. Look, check this out. Look, boom. So when I start digging on him, somebody say something nice. Yeah, that ain't nothing.
Mm-hmm.
If that dig a little bit more, I went to the football, the coaching people. I know some of y'all there. Yeah. Huh?
Right.
He did what? Mm-hmm. Then boom. People don't know this. One of my mentors' name is Kevin Franklin. He died of COVID. That's one of the suits, you know what I'm saying, that I be telling my stories about, that I was just ratchet, ignorant, and dumb. What up, doll? Say fall, cuz. Say look. Hey, say. I'm talking about ear. Mm-hmm. I remember it because I know what type of intellectual I've become.
Okay.
And what I can do now, I couldn't do that then, you know. So it's like, you know, but reading and getting smarter brought me a long way. But I say all that to say, I kept digging in the Coach, and I kept getting like stories that's like very, very pleasant. They know why I'm asking. And it's like, this the part I don't like. It's like, they don't want to tell me because they know I'm the crazy one who ain't scared to tell the truth.
Right.
That, what, he ain't did nothing? Wait, he really look, yeah, he ain't scared. He work at a Struma, and okay. But the crazy part about it, while I was helping a kid, I'm back. You see me? Somebody call, you know. I was trying to get a kid back, help him get back in school, and my people helped him get back in school into a Struma. And they had one of my partners from the streets, like, I'm talking about hood, like, he ain't no politician. Street cat. He say, man, I'm going to just say how he said it. You know what I'm saying? Man, they hating on the white coach over there. The white coach, the real one. I didn't know who we were talking about because he wasn't running yet.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? He said, the black one trying to get the white one out there. He said, I'm telling you, dog, that dude, make sure them kids straight. He really love them kids, man. I'm telling you, bro. The little dude who I was trying to get back in school, he was just like praying, the little dude, bro.
Mm-hmm.
It's sad that you got kids that want to be in school, caught up on minor infractions and bull crap, to where you could take the wrong book sack and people know when I talk what I be talking about, because I don't even post stuff like that when I help people. But I'm telling you that before then, I don't know if that was God softening me up. So I start feeling fake that I keep hearing all these stories. Then I hear about the viral story, and he not using none of this. Mm-hmm. And my marketing mind, I say, man, Coach ought to tell his stories. Like, I ain't with him. Mm-mm. Yeah, I got a solid no for him, but somebody on his team ought to tell him the stories.
Right, right.
And it's like, so I'm like, he reached out. Coach reached out, and I couldn't deny him a sit down because why? Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't I sit down? What did he do me?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So did you ask him in the conversation about the 10 years of no voting?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And, you know, he answered that on many interviews, too. Mm-hmm. You know, frustration with the choices. Okay. You know what I mean? Okay. And I understand that. I mean, that's why a lot of people sit out and don't even want to play the game because they feel like you're playing a game with us. Mm-hmm. And it is. It's weird. It's super weird. And it's like, I don't never have to play by no rules, though. Like that's why you got to watch who you deal with. Right. You know, I don't owe nobody. Like, you could tell who got to do what they got to do.
Right, right.
And you could tell who do what the fuck they want. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't even hold that curse word in because I do what the fuck I want.
Right.
And I'm sorry, any Christians on here, man. Look. And that Rebecca said shit when she first came on. It's ghetto ways. What you want? Yes, I.
So let's go ahead and try to redirect. So we got that clear. We got the business clear on, you know, your position of where you were supporting Sid. Now you are a clear supporter for Coach Sid. We got that part out the way. So hopefully some of the questions have been asked and answered. We have a lot going on in the chat. Like, we have a lot of comments going on about that, but we want to steer the conversation a little bit.
Like,
watch,
I'm telling you, the worst thing anybody, if you want to be a hater, do not research Coach Sid. If you start researching Coach Sid and you a real one, mm-hmm. you're going to say, huh? And you can say how you want, people can play how you want. Like, look at them comments. You read them. Don't I'm biased. I'm with him. So you ain't. You buy, you know.
The comments are there.
Like, and then like it, people got to know. Like, I'm not a gambling man. I'm crazy. I'm a little wild. You know what I mean? I'm a little brave, maybe, or maybe I'm just tired. And then nothing leaves nothing. So what you gonna do? Okay. What you gonna do? Yeah. Okay. Look at that. Being in more kids' living room than an Xmas tree. Who you talking about? I'll tell you this. I bet anybody in this city, and this is a sound bite. I bet you two things. If Coach lose, he ain't going to lose. But if Coach lose, he going to go right to the room and win a championship. Right? And still do what he been doing. Don't dig if you want to be a hater. If you locked in with somebody, do not research Coach Sid. Now, they say that sound backwards. I'm talking to haters. I'm talking about real folk.
Okay.
Cause real folk gonna say, that nigga Domino never lied to us. And every time he got one of the most honest things, he won an award for journalism. And when the police hit my daughter on the side of the head, he called me. And he I ain't gave him nothing. I ain't gave him not a nickel. But you know what? You don't owe me. I owe the game. Mm. I lived in darkness. I decided to come to the light. I gave in to the light. So now, no matter if it makes you mad, no matter if it burns your ass, no matter if it taints your soul, I got to do what I got to do to be honest and truthful at all times.
So let's talk about being truthful and honest at all times. You are now, you've changed your life. You've always been a family man, but now you are a dedicated, committed, 100% involved family man, grandfather. You started to bring in new talent such as myself, and you're building this entertainment empire. Why entertainment? Why media? Why, with all of the talents that you have, why stay in Baton Rouge with that?
Because as long as we have no control, no say over what we see every day. You got to think about how many times we saw something on video and we fought and we pro I protested. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't know what protesting was. People mix up rioting and protesting. Like, Baton Rouge thought we supposed to just tear up everything. You know what I'm saying? But me, I'm so real. If you try to diminish my character, if you lie on me, if you chop anything up or play with me like that, I'm then changed to where I'm not gonna do you nothing. But God bless you, because you'll never get around me again. You know what I'm saying? You'll never get around me again, man. You feel me? You can't let people burn you. You can't let people burn you, man. But if we don't ever have our own media, they could paint their own picture. I'm trying to figure out why news so black. And I'm not trying to be unfair. I'm trying to actually be balanced. Because I know they commit crime all across the board. You know what I mean? So it's like, why is the news so black? You know what I mean? That's what ghetto ways was. And then it's like, okay, y'all control that media. The people control this one. And then I accidentally could not manage that thing by myself. See, I don't mind telling the truth. You're gonna tell a story one day.
I mean, if you're gonna tell it, let's tell it.
I
That's
can't
what we
even
here
run the
for.
page right, y'all. I just got the password back when, Becca.
Probably what, 2 years ago?
After elections, man. Like, they don't even let me get the password. I just got it back, and I still ain't post, cause I ain't post on that mug in years. Like, I got on there one time, I got whooped so bad, they knew it wasn't the people who run it. It's like, I be trying to help out, but I like my page, cause I ain't no restriction.
So what is the ultimate
Well,
goal for
I need
getaways?
to correct that. It ain't really a restriction. It's got to be fair, or it ain't gonna go on there, cause it's like, when I think about some of the stuff y'all rejected, I understand it. Like I was, it was gonna be more, it was gonna jeopardize the page of getting reported. That's what people don't understand.
Correct.
That people love and like everything until they auntie house on them,
Correct.
you know. But you don't do WLB that, you know what I'm
Correct.
saying? And then, like, you know, the other thing that made me mad about it too is like everybody called WBRZ, called WLB, and then look over there, oh, look, get away. Oh, yeah. Hey, nobody helped us. Really? Duh. Because y'all do the same thing all the
So what is
time. You
the ultimate goal of getaways? Like, what is the direction?
know?
Because again, it goes to I get a lot of comments and messages and stuff where people are like, what are y'all doing? Like, what is the point? And I know we talked about this earlier on when we first started, but I want to circle back to it since we're talking about the media space that you're in. Where is the future for
I
getaways?
think the future gotta be, you know, Ghetto Ways success. Like they got one of our pages deleted at 50K. We shook back. We at 70 now. Is that 70 or something now? So it's like the people, and it's like I first thought it was just us. Man, Ghetto Ways got all kind of people on it, and I like that because election time had people thinking that we don't live and breathe and share and thrive with the other parties. I'm not foolish, not like that. Because Becca, where you get your black own gas from, and who's your black owned mortgage company that you got your lending from? I'm with Ally Financial. I don't that was the best thing I had at the time. I was just, you know, I don't know. Like, tell me where to look at Ghetto Ways. What the and see, look at my hand. There's no other phone. I'm holding
Right, I'm here
the
with y'all, so
I love
it's
y'all
not
though, man,
us.
because people don't know, you know, it's a that's like, you know, a dispatcher probably understand what Ghetto Ways is. Y'all don't know how much stuff we gotta cycle through. Man, we really a family, community company. Anything come in, we try to bust it down. Like real family, like, you know what I'm saying? Like it and I like how, like, it won't even take a shady nothing from nobody. Like, Becca can't do it because everybody gonna say nope, it's wrong, and they gonna look at what it's supposed to be and what's the goal, and gonna say I like it. You can do it on your page, but you know what I'm saying? And that's what make it so fair. I'm a Libra, so I don't mind being wrong. I'll tell y'all wrong. I apologize and, you know, all that stuff. But if you real and you want to see something that you never seen before, research. And then, like, for anybody that's out there working campaigns, I cracked the mold for influencers, man. You know, people gonna claim this and that, man, but I got a surefire way where you ain't got to sell out, you ain't got to eat no eggplant, you ain't got to sell your soul, you ain't got to sell your peach, you ain't got to do nothing. You could say, look, if you ever mess over old people, I never deal with you. You ever touch a child, I never deal with you. You ever hurt them seniors or start jacking and raping women, I can't deal with you. You got to have your boundaries and your bylaws, you know what I'm saying? Because thank you all for all y'all do. I can't tell who that is. I always try to read and guess who it is.
I don't know. It's not me, though.
Rebecca checked my temperature, man. Like, put it on wax. Rebecca checked me, you know what I'm saying? But nah, getaways, I feel like getaways is bigger than that. And, like, I'm really finna do, like, 100 podcasts because I really think I won't even let people go and talk that I don't agree with because I'm tired of suppression. You know, if you ain't with the fake, then research. Like, let people speak. Like, I still can 100% disagree with you. But my thing is, let them speak. Like, we might be to learn or we might be to debunk it. We might be to break it down. I ain't just talking. You know what I mean? But suppression and all this hatred, you know, it's like people want to act like they so pro-black, but all of them got a white partner somewhere. Like I show mine. I don't hide that. Mm-hmm. Like, you can't make me a racist. It's too much Creole over here, man. You look. Let me tell y'all something. I love everybody if you're righteous. Everybody else, man. God bless you. Cause guess what? I was dog too. Man, I don't be Ken. Look at this though.
So really, the ultimate goal, and I think where we are as getaways, I think what we are building towards is like a BET News,
real BET,
you know, a TV One News, you know, something that is for us by us, but that is fair across the board. You know, like you mentioned earlier, everyone loves getaways and what it does and how it gives our information in real time and all this stuff until it's them or someone that they're close to, and then it's a problem. Then it's the reporting of the post from 2019. This is all man, it's like,
talk about it, man. Like, man, wait. Hate be real, bro. Y'all don't know what we go through. It's like, man, like, I just say that I be giving it to God because we done lost so many pages, and it's like I keep rebuilding on them. Man, you know, it's like people want to hear what we got to say. People want to hear what we got going on, and it's like, I don't think people realize I accidentally came into that by just getting on here and saying how I feel. And I don't, if how I say something or what I say offend you, I don't keep going back to places I don't like. Like, I don't, it's kind of weird for people to be so uptight and in their feelings over somebody else's feelings when you can just remove yourself.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? We got to be real with ourselves. And it's like, you know, if anybody question my character, I'm standing with Coach. You hate game, don't research. If you want to see some facts, you want to see some truth, just dig. I ain't let you. I get arrogant, like I gamble like that at times. Like, if I know I got you, you know what I'm saying? If I know I got you, I'm talking. No, that's what I do. I talk when I got you.
I think one of the biggest, the most, I don't know, I want to say interesting moments for me with getaways has been when the national news picks up our stories and either gives credit or doesn't give credit.
Right.
You cook my grits when you don't give credit because New York Times is just not floating around in bedrooms. Like, come on. So you got it from somewhere. You know what I'm saying? So give us our credit. Give us our props for that. And I think the second biggest thing that would be the most memorable for me would be the support that we showed to Rouge Cafe when we went and we did some video and we commented and, you know, we responded to some comments. And I gave my portion about me being a foodie. And a lot of people was in my DMs and in my comments, like, well, who are you? And all this stuff. And you know, my response is always Google me. I mean, it's facts.
I love it. Ain't nothing wrong with loving yourself. Like that. However, anybody who watched that and see that wrong, that was beauty to me because that showed, you know, I got some stuff going on, baby. It ain't no. Why people be feeling so bad when people figure they stuff out, man? You know what I'm saying?
I think it was a lot of just people with their own personal vendettas against that business owner. Unfortunately, I don't even know if they are still in operation because there was some changes happening. However, the point was to go and show support to Black-owned businesses in Baton Rouge.
And see for ourselves.
I feel that we did our service by going and supporting that restaurant, as well as the others that we've supported, at least since I've been a part of Getaways. And so, you know, we're always like, hey, if there's somebody out there, send it to us, refer us, let us know what's going on, and we'll come and we'll show support, we'll show love. But I think people get a little afraid when we show up.
Ah, I don't know why. We nice as I don't know what. We sweet as pie. My favorite Getaways moments, gonna have to be top three. I'm talking about closing Second Chance, school board meeting with Big A. That I ain't gonna lie, that Chris Nakamoto. What's up, Coach? Look at Coach. I bet you won't. This ain't we clicking in? Yeah,
clicking in. My dog out. Coach Steed, if you would like to join us on this live, you are welcome to. We'll definitely bring you in so that some of the questions.
Say he's also watching this live. He's watching this live.
He's watching it live. Come on. So if you want to join us, we'll be more than happy to tag you in so that we can circle back to some of the comments that we've had. And you know, if you are at the moment, you know, you want to answer the questions, you can. If not, we will definitely bring you back to Touch Taste Thursday so that we can have a one-on-one conversation.
Why this, Becca? 8:43? He might be able to get on, but he got a lot of stuff to do. Like,
hey, listen, like, facts, I understand.
Yeah, I give my jambalaya back to you. Oh, no, I need it. Please send it to me. Please send it
to me. So I met Tyrone last night at Capital City Wealth Builders event at the Vivint office by LSU. Mm-hmm. And he was like, I keep seeing you on my feed. Who are you? Like, what are you doing? I was like, I don't know what you're seeing, but like, what's up? And so when he told me about his jambalaya pack, I was like, I definitely need that. Mm-hmm. So shout out to you, Fork and Right. I'm definitely going to get that jambalaya. So I'm going to get mine Saturday, Johnny. Whenever you get yours, you can pick mine too.
Yeah, bring it to me. Bring it to me, man.
Yes.
I'm going to vote tomorrow. Early voting is tomorrow, you know.
Early voting.
And like I say, man, y'all can't get you. I know I got a voice, and when I say it, it's different, and I understand all that. But I ain't gonna let that suppress me telling. Say, I've been telling y'all how I feel. Why you mad now?
Not how you mad. All right, like, we got Gene on the line.
Gene on the line.
Gene coming in on the
line. Why would it rub anybody wrong? Am I the liar? G on there. Look, dig on the Bun P thing. Let's do the disclaimer right now. Well, I'm Pimp C. That's Bun B. Don't blame Bun B for what Pimp C do. I'm my own man. Y'all don't give him a hard time for me, bro, because I'm weird. I'm different.
And that's the first thing I want to tell y'all. And Becca know this, right? I disagree with everything Johnny said. Me and him never agree.
No, nine out of 10.
Okay, all right.
Nine out of 10.
Let's regroup. All right, y'all. That's enough.
Look, that's her. That's her and me and Gene argument.
I'm the peacemaker.
That's her and me and Gene argument.
Yeah, Becca's always the peacemaker. Me and Johnny go at it pretty rough. Me and Johnny are definitely on the opposite ends of the spectrum. Like, you know, Becca,
right.
I have called Johnny a Republican, not in a good way, a lot, right? You know, but you know, like that's part of what like makes us a good, you know, kind of group because like we all got kind of I disagree with Johnny all the time. like all the time. Like I told Johnny, I said, man, look, I don't agree with nothing you're doing. And Becca, like you said, you're a secretary. Like I feel like that too because Johnny do something, I get the call.
Mm-hmm.
I get the kicks, right?
Right.
I can't even stay over here a long time tonight because I ain't gonna agree with nothing Johnny say tonight. Like not nothing. you know.
Now this is a sound bite too. You know? Cause look, I do my thing, baby. And look, I stand on everything I say. Challenge me like she did. If I'm lying, call me out. You know what I'm saying? That's what I mean. And look, they love me. They say, don't do that. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. That'd be me. I don't give a I'm gonna do it. I mean it. That's why I'm gonna do it. Yeah, but this, huh? I don't agree with you, but hey, man, I can't stop you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, man, it ain't about me going against nobody that's close to me. It's about me staying true to what I feel inside my core and my gut, bro. Mm-hmm. It ain't. It, and I'm sorry to y'all on here. You know, even Big A, you know how we got to, you know how he, him too. You know what I'm saying? We done went out there, Big A supposed to be security. And we done had to go get Big A one time. You know what I'm saying? It's like he ended up in the front. Gene ain't agree with Big A doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Big A, no.
I was begging Big A. I'm like, Big A, stop. Please stop.
Right.
And if you ever seen Big A, you're not going to stop Big A if you want.
Can't
you
stop
him. No, you can't stop Big A, man.
Yeah,
good luck.
But, you know, but I will tell you this. Like me and Johnny, this particular political season, right? We've been like sometimes not agreeing on like support, right? Right now I don't agree with Johnny, right? But at the same time, I you gotta be okay with that. And it was, you know, Johnny's still a part of my team, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna disagree with Johnny again tomorrow because we're gonna talk about it tomorrow, and I'm gonna disagree with him again tomorrow. I disagree with him before. I disagree with him when he did it. And he gonna disagree with me, right?
Yeah.
And this is the thing that Becca, you know this a lot. And I guess Becca, you experience it to some extent, right? Because you get the messages and stuff too. When Johnny do something, folks will call me and they'll blame me from one aspect of things, mm-hmm. right? One side of the community. And then you know, if it's something that's more on the streets, they gonna call Johnny and blame Johnny, right?
right.
So some of that's just how I roll, but yeah, like literally, and I'm gonna say this again, I rarely agree with Johnny Domino.
Right.
But, you know, it's his right to say it, you know? Yeah. I definitely disagree with him. Like I'm supporting Mayor Brooklyn, and I believe that she's the most intentional mayor for positive change that we've ever seen in my lifetime, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's just what it is. Johnny disagrees with me.
100%.
Heated arguments about that, right?
Yeah, for sure.
We have had heated arguments about that. And I've tried to sway him, but I've tried to convince him, and there is no swaying or convincing
that's
Johnny Domino.
Fact.
He is his own man. He gonna roll his own way. He got his own thoughts. Now, if he bump his head, I ain't gonna lie on him, he'll come back and be like, Gene, man, you're right.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Tell him. That's why I stand on my word so much, because guess what? I'm wrong. I could be wrong.
He does frustrate me because he got to bump his head first, right?
Mm-hmm.
He got to bump his head first. But when he does, he always, like, I've known him to always come back and apologize.
Mm-hmm.
And tell you, like, hey, man, you were right, Gene. And Becky.
Sound like you cut out, Gene.
Can't hear him no more. Yeah. But yeah, nah, like, I ain't gonna lie, like the thing with me is, like, I'm coming from a whole nother mm-hmm. walk, right?
Mm-hmm.
So when something look fake or something don't look real or something don't add up or the mouth don't mouth, I don't have no connection to nobody. Mm-hmm. I'm not your friend. I'm not your pop. I'm his friend. And he mad. He don't agree with me and my choice, but I don't agree with the voters that got him in the runoff. See? See what I'm saying? I don't agree with the voters that got the man that did that much service to be in a runoff with who? Who you compare Eugene Collins to? No,
that's not my thoughts. Cause again,
I know.
I get the messages like I'm y'all secretary, and the question is,
nah, you've been not called the secretary. About, no, you are talent.
I'm telling you what the message, and I'm like, oh, but the messages and the comments and the question was about, you know, and we're shifting gears because we started talking about one particular race and now we're talking about something different. But then the comments and the questions was about, you know, does Eugene really live in his district? And I'm like, I've seen him there. That's where we meet at. So, yeah.
Look, that's the education piece, though, Beck. They don't know that school board and council is different. It's a different time parameter, but I didn't know either. And then, like, when people ask me, man, what's up with your boy? Like, I act like I don't get nothing else from ghetto ways. You know what I'm saying? Every post, they think I did. You know what I'm saying? I get it, too. Yeah, well, hey, Gene, what's up with Gene? I say, Gene. They say, what's up with Gene? Say, let me show you the rule. And he teach me. You know what I'm saying? And so I read the rule. That's why I love him, because he don't hide it from me. That's why I can stand with him, because he don't hide nothing. You see what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like, I've been making it this long, how I've been making it, and you gotta think about what I'm known for.
So let's redirect again.
Come on.
This is our third redirection, but in the meantime, let me welcome everyone that's joining. Yeah. This is Touch Taste Thursday, season 7. If you are not familiar with me or Touch Taste Thursday, I am Rebecca with a K. I originally started out on the Gene Ellen Collection, which is my business brand on Instagram, doing IG Lives with people from around the country that are of influence, whether they were local celebrities, national celebrities, major celebrities, celebrities in their mind, entrepreneurs, whoever they were, and they wanted to tell their story. That was why they were brought to Touch Taste Thursday. And I also started out as a product reviewer. So that's where the Touch Taste part come in 2020. It is now 2024. That's 4 years. This is season 7. It's all documented. You can Google me. All of it is there. That's going to always be my tagline. You can Google me. I am on LinkedIn. I'm on YouTube. I'm on wherever. So you can always see all of my information and my documented history that IG Live, podcasting, video, vlogs, whatever you want to call this, that is what I do, and I've done it. And so now we are in a different season where we are podcasting again, but we're doing it from the Rebecca with a K side, because Rebecca with a K is the personality. I am Rebecca with a K, and this is Touch Taste Thursday, season 7. My guest tonight is Johnny Domino of Ghetto Ways 2.0, Johnny Domino Productions. You just know him as someone who is, I guess, a renaissance man. Like, you do it all.
Yeah, so, man. God,
now we are doing like the videos, we're doing the podcast, we have the Ghettoways Studio, Ghettoways Media. Ghettoways has done some music production and video production and all of these different things. And so how do you keep all of those trains moving in the right direction so that they don't crash into each other?
I ain't nothing without y'all. I hate to show my weak point, but man, without that team, man, like, people don't realize how many people we help. Like, that we say nothing about, that we ask for nothing, that we just want to please God. It's like we help so many people that when we really doing something for you, it's in the spare time after working 8:30 to 6, you know what I'm saying? Getting off at 6, taking 2 meetings, trying to see who need this, who need that, who needs something done legally, you know, 100% legal,
right.
You know?
Right.
I mean, I got to say that because I'm proud of that. I was illegal, and I wouldn't have told you that if I wouldn't have changed, because I know how to hide my hand. That's what I was known for, hiding my hand. And you hide your hand for so long, you just keep looking up and he see everything you do. So it's like, why hide it?
Yeah.
Tell people what you ain't gonna never do again.
Right.
You know, convict yourself. Come clean. Like, let it go. You know what I'm saying? The deeper you get spiritual, you ain't finna be playing with God. It don't matter who on board. It don't matter if you by yourself. You feel it, you know that. You spiritual too. See, that's why I like you. You a multi-host. When I'm looking for hosts, y'all would make me pick Becca. Let's do this. When I saw her, she was together. She was on point. She was fresh. She was well spoken. She interviewed and engaged well. And I'm like, I do this to everybody. I'm sorry. And I do it in my head. If y'all wouldn't know if I didn't tell you. I'm like, I'm a hater at first because I want to see if it's overwhelmingly good. I ain't giving it no false credit. I'm hating on it first. What can I hate on? Because when you hate on it first in your head, not out loud, y'all. What up, baby? When you hate in your head, you can see what they need to fix. And now you see if they ever get into the engagement and want to construct the criticism, then you can give them the stuff that you see that people could hate on you on.
Right.
Right? Before, so now it's a blessing. You took hate and you turn it to love. Before they can hate on you for this, man, you slip showing. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, do this and do this, and then when you project and when you do this and two fingers from the mic, you know, the little media stuff that Missy Radio and working at 94.9 and, you know, I done lived a lot of lives, man. That's mm-hmm. why I can't write one book.
Mm-hmm.
I got to write a bunch of them. Man, I love my realness, too, because I ain't got to remember nothing. I just tell you what it was. It's going to be the same thing when you get back. If the shirt was blue, it was blue.
Right.
I'm not going to call it red. I ain't going to call it orange. It's blue. It was blue. Don't know what color that shirt was. Blue. See, you ain't got to lie.
You
got to remember a lie.
Right.
Nah, thank you, though. I appreciate you. But nah, that's how I critique music. Mm-hmm. I listen to music in threes. A lot of stuff I do in threes is like a bad habit. And then I make it biblical, like, you know, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So boom, there you go. Three times with three is in together. You know what I'm saying? I just listen to it with a biased ear. Then I listen to it on an unbiased ear. Look for all the strong points.
Gotcha.
And I do that with everything. So when I kept looking at you, you had did like, I filmed like eight interviews, six or eight people, and we were in there for a long time.
Right.
And one thing I liked that I wasn't ready to leave. I wasn't tired of filming y'all, like, oh, it's boring. Ugh. You know, film people got film, what you got to film if it's a paid for high gig. Ghetto Ways, it was like, you know, that's my people. Shout out to Phaedra and her film production and all that, man. So, you know, Phaedra, you know, people got to learn love and support and bartering and stuff like that because me trying to help Phaedra and do a good deed for my people, because that's what I'm supposed to do, I found you. And I'm like, man, that chick dope. Like, by the time I was finished, I was like, I just got to ask her, I was looking for stuff. What can I give her? What I need something. You know what I'm saying? And then I just came at you straight up and told you what it was, told you what you can do, how we structure this thing. And you came in very energetic. You stayed strong no matter what. Like, I love your transparency as well, because you know how to tell people what they did and it don't hurt as bad. you like frank, but it's like, it's straightforward, but it's sweet though. It's like, you didn't do that. It wasn't like, you ain't do that. It wasn't like, you know, it's like, you did not do that. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I didn't do it, but it don't hurt like a sting. You know what I mean? Some people tell you stuff in this thing. They just sound like, you know, it's women out here sound like men too. It's just some DMX auntie type thing going on. People with just everybody rough and hard. So I just try to be sweet all the time. Tell everybody God bless them. Because saying F you ain't gonna get you nowhere. You know what I'm saying?
Nowhere. Not a place.
You can insult me today. Get what I might tell you. Man, God bless you, man. Let me get on from around you. You know what I'm saying? Because, nah, man.
You
got to
comment and say she's sweet as pie, but she got a bite. I do.
Yeah.
I ain't even
going to
hold you.
It's righteous, though, man. You know, a lot of people we caught whoopings when we were little. They wasn't whooping us because we were good. We were whooping us because we had did wrong, man. You know? And I don't even like whoopings. I've been trying to solve parenting, and my 2-year-old been winning. Like, he do what he want. But I got to try everything. I tried dog. Got to try light. Tried whooping them grown children. I got 2-year-old. I'm a pawpaw, too. Ooh. Yeah. Man, I got to just write a bunch of books, Becca. There's just so many layers. Early pawpaw. Look at what pawpaw look like right now. Me and Sharonda Gold and my dog, young boy mama. This she a grandma. I'm a grandpa. We still in the club.
At some point, somebody ought to either stop being in clubs, stop having kids, or realize like it's time to go ahead and, you know, make some changes. But no, let's go ahead and wrap this up. It is 9 o'clock, and so we don't want to hold you. We thank you all for joining us tonight. I hope that you all have enjoyed Touch Taste Thursday season 7, episode 1. You know, it's been a minute. I knew I kind of left y'all hanging for a while. I was just trying to figure some things out. You know, like I said, it was a lot of people that have come in and out of my life over the last couple of years that's been like, hey, I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to make you a star. I want to do all of these things. And, you know, sometimes when you have a dream and you feel like, okay, this person is going to take me to that level, let me see where it goes, and it lets you down. You just kind of get into a shell where you're like, man, okay, let me regroup. Let me figure out my next steps. And, you know, then life be life and stuff happens. And I done took on like 18 different jobs in the last couple of months. And, like, I'm always doing something. Yeah, like, you know, and I recognize that people recognize my talent, my value, and what I can bring to them and help them. And so it has become a mission of mine to help people build their brands and build their profiles, in which I've had successfully for quite a few people, and a lot of people you don't even know that I am behind the scenes on them, because it's not for me to share their business. That's on them if they want to tell you or not. And then, you know, the check clear. So that's all that matters, is the check clear. Right. But again, I do want to thank you all. I haven't decided if I want to go back to doing every week or every 2 weeks, but just wait. So make sure you stay locked in to my social media for when a flyer posts, or if there's something going on for getaways and we're out and about, come make sure you pull up on us, come support. I will say, as a public announcement, you all need to make sure you are being mindful of what's going on in the special tax session. Right now, the legislators are in a special tax session, and I keep saying tax because it's supposed to be about our taxes. But there is what's called Senate Bill 2, which is, to break it down the best way I can, which states that any child of any age for any crime will be charged as an adult. Any child of any age for any crime will be charged as an adult. So that basically illuminates, or it basically eradicates juvenile detention or the juvenile system. It just takes your kids straight to jail. And when we say to jail, we mean parish, prison, or to Angola. And so you have to be mindful, sir, ma'am. Make sure you are staying connected to Getaways, because we're going to give you the real. Today was posted about who voted against Senate Bill 2. Of course, across the board, it was our African-American representatives and senators that voted no, because they do not believe that our children should be charged as adults for any crime if they're under the age of 18. And so we have to be mindful. We have to do our due diligence. We also have to make sure we are going out and voting. We do have an election coming up December 7th. I know it is an away game. I think it's an away Saints game. It's a whole lot of stuff going on that day, but early voting is now beginning. So you can go out and early vote for our mayoral election, as well as all of the upcoming things that's changed during this legislative session that they've snuck in under the radar. And so I want to make sure that you all are well informed. And I also want to always, always make sure you all know the truth about what is going on in our city, in our state, and surrounding areas. So that is all for tonight. I'm Rebecca with a K. Hey, make sure you are following, you like, make sure you share this live, make sure you tag us in the giveaways. I didn't realize like there was some rappers doing giveaways today, and there wasn't no shade to anybody. Yeah. It was just the fact that like entertainment, athletes, rappers, they all like to start doing giveaways around the holidays, and so that was just coincidental. So that was no shade, but that was definitely on me. So y'all have a good night.
Thank you for having me.
Amazing. Thank you for being on the show tonight, Johnny. And you know we gonna run it again probably later.
Man, check me anytime, Becca. Hey, I ain't got nothing to hide.
That is what I do. I'm the fact checker.
I love it.
All right, everyone. Y'all have a great night. It's time for Law and Order. Gotta go. Bye.